Hello, my name is Jess Richter Klug and I will talk about our dataset of stored kitchen object. We recorded binary client RGBD images and annotated them with 60 poses. In a common kitchen, you will always find a lot of places where objects are stored in highly cluttered scenes. For example, inside a drawer, inside a dishwasher, or inside a cupboard. These scenes are the one we are interested in. So the images they are shown here are actually directly out of our dataset. For each object inside the scene, we provide a 60 pose. For these example images, we can see the rendered pose here as an overlay. A robot must be able to fetch household objects from cupboards, drawers, and out of dishwashers so that it can be deployed in a common household. And these scenes are especially hard to detect because in it objects are mostly tightly packed or even stacked and thus highly occluded. Also, all objects that can be seen have no texture, maybe are transparent and/or reflective. The wanted scenes are poorly observable. This makes not only the challenge for the robot to detect any objects at all, but it also prevents established method to generate or annotate ground truth data for these scenes. In addition, manual annotation would be introducing an unfeasible amount of labor work. Therefore, our approach is following. We locate objects with the tracking system once when placed. Having once registered an object inside the tracking system, we do not move this object at all. Therefore, at the end, even though an object might not be seen in the tracking system, we know its pose from before. We can then record video sequences while the camera has also been tracked, and afterwards we can extract the corresponding poses for each object in each camera frame. By recording additional video sequences during different setup stages, we can further increase the size of our recorded data without increasing the workload. This is reasonable since a scene with just 15 or 40 objects is quite different from the final result. So what is actually in the dataset? In the main part of the dataset, we show all our selected objects stored in cupboards and drawers, and we also provide an additional scene with subscenes, which shows a selected subgroup of the objects stored in the dishwashers. Each scene is observed through two cameras. We have at one the Kinect, which provides RGBD images, and second, the RC Wizard, which provides binocular RGB image. For each frame, we provide a pose annotation for one as one data, but also we projected the data into the image with the object model, so we have semantic segmentation and instance segmentation. All the objects we used inside the datasets can be seen here. We have porcelain objects, classy objects, and metallic objects. We especially selected a few objects that look the same but just differ in size. We also selected some black objects because they are even harder to detect. The maximum amount of one object that can be found inside one image is shown via the number in each image. All marked objects with an X can also be seen in the dishwasher scene. For an overview of the object sizes, we have here a sorted list of the object's diameters. We can see that the most objects have a diameter between 15 and 30 centimeters, but we have also objects from 6 to 40 centimeters. To get an expression what our dataset actually looks like, we have here some sample images. On this slide, we see sample images recorded by the Kinect camera. On the left, we have the RGB image and also the depth image from the Kinect. For each image, we provide a class segmentation and then the insect segmentation, which are based on the actual posts, which are also provided in a JSON file. On this slide, you get an expression which image the Acer Wizard camera provides. Instead of a color and a depth image, we have here a left and a right eye image. Of course, for each image, we again provide class segmentation and instance segmentation and also the raw post data. The Acer Wizard camera would also provide an binocular-based depth image, but for far less frames, and therefore it's not shown here. To summarize, we provide a dataset of realistically packed crockery items in commonly kitchen. Objects are there tightly packed or even stacked and thus highly occluded, and all objects are textureless and mostly transparent and or reflective. Our ground truth data are not 100% correct. This is due to the tracking system what is used to generate them. In our paper, we conducted an extensive accuracy evaluation. In short, its result is that the ground truth poses are accurate to 3.5 mm ADD. This means if a pose is assumed to be correct, if its error is smaller than 10% of its diameter, for all but two objects, our ground truth poses are more than threefold accurate. This concludes my talk. Thank you for your attention.